Hello everyone, how are you? Hope you are doing very well. So welcome to our English class. Today we will learn about possessive nouns and pronouns. During this class time, we will cover page 304 and 305 from your reader's notebook, which is your big book. And we will also cover page 118 and 119 from your journey, which is your small book. So if you are ready, let's get started. Right now, please open page 304 from your reader's notebook, which is your big book. Okay, let's read about a possessive noun. What does it mean? A possessive noun shows that a person or animal owns or has something. How can I show it? So, for example, in this one, I have a noun here. After an apostrophe, I'll put S. If it is singular, but if it is plural and if it's not finished with s, in this situation I'll do the same thing. So this is my plural noun. Children represent more than one child. So after children, I need to put apostrophe and then I need to add s. But girls represent more than one girl. So, in this situation, for this plural noun, I need to put just apostrophe. It's already finished with S. So, I don't need to put one more S here. Okay? So, what about a possessive pronoun? What does it mean? A possessive pronoun can take the place of a possessive noun to show who or what owns something. In this example, I know boys bike. The other one is dogs toys. What about possessive pronoun? So for singular one, I can say her, his, my, mine. For plural, I can use our, ours, their, theirs. In the example, I use my bike, our books. In the other example, I know this bike for who? Boy's bike. So if I want to use possessive pronoun for this example, I can use his bike. Instead of boy's, I put his. His bike. Okay? Let's check the exercise now. Page 304 from your reader's notebook, from your big book. Okay, it says copy each sentence. Fill in the blank with the correct possessive noun or pronoun. Okay, let's check the first sentence together. The bike woke me up. After the, it's already given here. I need to write dog. But dogs bark, right? How can I write it? I need to put an apostrophe and then I need to add S for singular nouns. So, dog is already singular. What about second sentence? The toy is on the table. Baby. It is singular or plural? Let's decide it. Perfect. This is singular. So, in this situation, I need to put an apostrophe after baby and then I need to add S at the end of baby. So, it will be the baby's toy is on the table. Okay, let's check third sentence together. The toys are on the floor. Babies. This time babies. Is it plural or singular? Good job. This is plural. And it's finished with S. In this situation, what should I write? So, I just need to add an apostrophe at the end of babies. I don't need to write one more S here because this S is already given to me here. I cannot write one more S here. It will be the baby's toys are on the floor. What about fourth sentence? Let's read it together. The students cheered for team. So it's given to me. The students. Students already plural. And after students, I just add one an apostrophe, right? So in this one, what can I write instead of the students team? This is also right, the student's team. But if I want to use this time possessive pronoun, remember pronouns, her, his, my, their, our. So which one is the correct one here? The students, whose team? Their team, right? The students cheered for their team. Okay, good job. If you are ready, please open page 118 from your journey, which is your small book. Let's talk about singular possessive nouns more. It says a singular possessive noun shows that a person, animal, place or thing has or owns something. So at the end of it, for example, if I want to check the example sentence, it says the backpacks, straps were loose. So after the singular noun, I just need to add an apostrophe and then I need to add a S here. Let's check the second sentence. Oliver's backpack was once home to a mouse. So Oliver, this is my singular noun. After Oliver, I add an apostrophe and then S. For singular noun, all of them is same. Just an apostrophe and then put S. Okay, let's check your exercise on the same page. Page 118 from your journey. Let's read the question together. It say, write the possessive for each noun below. So, let's check. All of them is singular. Friend, Emma, bus station, river, Florida, and car. All of these verbs are singular, right? So, for singular verbs, let's check. What should I write? An apostrophe and then S for all of them. So, for friends, how can I write it as possessive noun? I need to write friends. I need to write the original word and then I just need to add an apostrophe and then S. Friends. Good. What about the second one? Emma. How can I make it possessive noun? Emma's, right? Good job. What about bus station? How can I write it? Bus stations. Good job. So, check it. I always write the original word, then I add an apostrophe, then I add S. Good. What about river? How can I make it a possessive noun? So, I'll do the same thing, right? Rivers. First, I'll write the word river, and then I need to add an apostrophe, and then I need to add S. Good job. What about Florida? How can I make it a possessive noun? Florida's, right? Good job. I'll write the original word, which is Florida in this example. After that, I need to add an apostrophe and then S. For all of them, I'm doing the same thing if it is singular noun. What about car? Car is also a singular noun. How can I make it a possessive noun? First of all, I need to write the original word, which is car. And then I need to add an apostrophe. And then I need to add S. Cars. Good job. You are doing very well. Okay. Let's check the other exercise. It say, underline the noun that should be possessive and write the possessive form. Okay, let's read the sentence together. The man's hobby was to build furniture. Which one is possessive? Whose hobby? This hobby belongs to who? The man, right? So it belongs to man. The man's hobby, but something wrong here. Which one is wrong? The man. Instead of man, I need to write man's. The man's hobby was to build furniture. So it say underline. If you want, you can underline it. But I want to make it clear for you. Because of this, I circle them. The man's hobby was to build furniture. What about next sentence? The workshop tools hang neatly on the wall? Okay. Which one should be a possessive noun? Good job. The workshop's tools, right? These tools belongs to who? Or where? The workshop. Okay, I need to circle workshop, and workshop is a singular noun. How can I make it possessive? I need to write workshop, the original word, and then I need to add an apostrophe, and then I need to add S. Good job. Okay, let's read the next sentence together. His niece's birthday was next week. Whose birthday? His niece's birthday, right? But something is missing here, right? So let's circle it first. And how can I write it? Niece is a singular noun. So because of this, I need to add an apostrophe after niece, and then I need to write S. What about next sentence? The day course would have to wait until he completed the gifts. Okay. Which one is can be a possessive noun? The day course. Course. Whose course? Where is it? Okay. The days. It should be days, right? So, instead of day, I know day is a singular noun. Because of this, I just need to add an apostrophe, and then I need to add S. Good job. Okay, right now let's check page 119 from your journey, which is your small book. Right now let's talk about plural possessive noun. Until now we talk about singular possessive nouns. What we did, we always add an apostrophe and then S. But plural possessive nouns is kind of different. Be careful about it. Okay, how can I show it? Let's check my exercise. It says, Raymond put the sister's postcards in the mail. Sisters, this is plural, right? Because it's finished with S. If it is finished with S, I just need to add an apostrophe. Just this. But the children's letters were from all over the country. Children represent more than one child. We say they are irregular plural nouns. So, children represent a plural noun, but there is no S at the end of it. In this situation, it will be like singular nouns. I'll just add an apostrophe, and then I need to add S. It will be like singular nouns. But if there is S at the end of my word, in this situation, I just need to add an apostrophe. That's all. Okay, let's check my exercise now on the same page. Let's read the question. It says, write the possessive form of the plural nouns. Man, babies, books, fish, and shells. How can I write them? Okay, fish. First of all, man. Man is a plural noun. How can I make it possessive? Man. I need to check the last letter here. Is it finished with S or not? No, there is no S here. In this situation, I need to do it like singular nouns. So, I write man. And then I need to add an apostrophe and then S. Remember, man is also plural, but it's not finished with S here. Because of this, I put an apostrophe, then S. What about second word? It say babies. This is also plural, but this time it's finished with S. If it's finished with S, what should I write? Perfect. I just need to add an apostrophe. I don't need to add an S here. Okay, because it's already finished with S. I cannot write S here. Okay, what about books? Books is also my plural noun. How can I make it possessive? Let's check the last letter. Books. It's finished with S, right? In this situation, what should I write? I just need to put an apostrophe. I don't need to write S here. Books, the original word, and then just an apostrophe. What about fish? I need to check the last letter here. Fish, is it finished with S? No. In this situation, I just need to put an apostrophe, then S. Remember, man and fish, they are not finished with S. Because of this, I put an apostrophe, then S. But for babies and for books, they finish with S. Because of this, I just need to add an apostrophe. I don't need to write an S. What about shelves? It's a plural noun. It's finished with S. What should I write? Okay, perfect. I just need to add an apostrophe because it's already finished with S. Check them. Shelves, books, babies, all of them finish with S. If they finish with S, I don't need to write one more S here. I'll just add an apostrophe. Good job. Okay, let's write sentence. It say on the same page 119 from your journey, which is your small book. It say write sentences for three of the possessive plural nouns. So you can check the words from here and you can write your sentence. You can construct your sentence by your own way. So right now, for example, let's check what I write. The baby's cries make me feel sad. Who is cries? Who is crying? The babies. Babies, an apostrophe, cries, make me feel sad. What about, how can I make it a possessive pronoun? Their cries, because check it, babies. I can make it their cries make me feel sad, right? Okay, let's check the next sentence together. The book's cover pages were so interesting. The books. Cover page belongs to what? The books. Their cover page. So books is already plural. It's already finished with S. Because of this, I can just add an apostrophe. So the books cover page were so interesting. Let's check the last sentence. The man's cars are so fast. So the man. Man is also a plural noun, but it's not finished with S. In this situation, I just need to put an apostrophe and then I need to add S. The man's cars are so fast. Good job. You are doing very well. Thank you so much. Take care of you.